Well, first of all, I don't like the elite versus populist definition, which is too big.
But it's one that Enrico Letta's made a lot of comments about and says this is what Italy needs to grasp. This is what Europe needs to grasp.
Yeah, I mean, it is a definition, but from my point of view, it's a too standard definition. Here, what we do, we represent entrepreneurs and top executives. We represent the community who invests for the future. And by doing investments, you create new jobs, and by creating new jobs, you create opportunity for growth. And my mantra as the European House Ambrosetti, first Italian private think tank, is no growth, no future. So if we want to have a future, we need to listen to the expectations of the investors, the industrialists, the entrepreneurs who actually risks everything in order to create opportunities for themselves, of course, but also for employees. And that issue of enhancing and stimulating investments, private investments, is actually a priority in this country.
So why do I have so many amazing conversations at Ambrosetti every year with so many fantastic CEOs and politicians and academics, and then I see the state of Italy, I see the lack of structural reform, I see the lack of infrastructure spending, which has become oh so topical in 2018, the lack of progress in reforming a banking sector, in getting down non-performing loans. Italy is an amazing country, we love it, we've great people. Why is it all these great conversations here at the European House Ambrosetti don't translate into better policy?
Well, I partly disagree with all your statements. For instance, it's not true at all that the banking sector is suffering. It's one of the more solid of Europe.
It's got a quarter of all European non-performing loans, sir.
Well, but we manage those amount of non-performing loans, and we are in a much better position now than we were at the explosion of the Lehman Brothers crisis 15 September 2008, exactly 10 years ago. So much in a better, more solid position in terms of banking sector overall in Italy. And also in addition to that, Italy is the country within Europe who invested the least public money in saving the banks. The first in class was England, and then Germany, and then Spain, and then all the others. Italy did very little public money to save the Italian banking system. But having said that, I don't want to, have a confrontation with you on everything. I agree on the fact that in terms of infrastructure, we are lagging behind. We need a lot of long-term investments and plans in infrastructure. And that is very evident. We really need that. The problem is that if you invest in infrastructure, in education, in research, you invest in the long term, and you don't get elections votes tomorrow morning. If you invest in giving back to Italians short-term money, like with the flat tax or like with some of the ideas that are in the political agenda and discussion, you get short-term elections. So you're perfectly right. We really need to have, as a hope, a longer-term point of view in terms of perspective in Italy, in the country.
And just finally, just going back to the very clear danger for the markets, and that is Mr. Tria's inability to control the policy excesses of his deputy prime ministers, because many people believe they are the true power brokers in the country.
Let me correct you immediately. Mr. Tria, for the moment, he has demonstrated he's actually stopping the two prime ministers' requests. As a matter of fact, after his last points, we have regained more than 50 points in the spread, BTP versus Bund. So for the moment, I'm not saying this is a promise for the future. For the moment, he is controlling those promises.
So when the draft budget goes to the Commission in Brussels on the 15th of October, Tria will have maybe a sub 2% deficit of GDP to hand over to the Commission and say, look what I've done. You're very confident of that.
I'm very much confident. And in fact, we made a lot of declarations here in your nice program, compliments for it, by the way. I'm ready to bet with you that our plan would be around 2.5, no more than that, which is largely below the 3% or above that was promised by the two deputy prime ministers.
Valerio, let's see, and let's hope that's enough to keep the Italian debt to GDP at no more than the current levels. Thank you very much indeed for your time.
Hey everybody, it's Hadley Gamble from our new CNBC Middle East Bureau in Abu Dhabi. Thanks for stopping by. Now to watch more, you can try one of the videos that just popped up on your screen. And don't forget to subscribe.